Hey everyone, welcome back to Dub Support YouTube channel. In today's video, we're talking about Brightcove and its alternative, Dub. So to say that the two platforms are interchangeable or a complete replacement for each other would not be accurate. So there are gonna be different aspects of these platforms that are definitely interchangeable, and that's what we're gonna actually be comparing today. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. We have Brightcove on the left and Dub on the right. So the first thing that I was gonna say is those comparable aspects of these two platforms. One is Brightcove's video cloud option, video hosting solution, and Dub's video hosting solution, and then also Brightcove's marketing solution they have. You can see I have that selected here. So those two platforms and plans actually are very comparable, as well as some of the elements of the enterprise comm solution that they offer as well. So those are the products that we're going to be comparing today, is Brightcove's marketing solution, their video cloud solution, and then Dub's marketing and cloud solution that is in one package. So let's go ahead and dive into it. First, we're going to go ahead and take a look at Brightcove's. We're going to take a look at Brightcove. So you can see here, this is what's included in the marketing suite. So we're talking about video portals, which are customizable video landing pages where you're able to kind of build them out using built-in templates. Also content management, where you have your library of videos. And by marketing automation, what they really mean is just integrations into existing marketing automation platforms like HubSpot or Marketo or Pardot, things like that. And then also integrations with CRM platforms with also HubSpot and things like that. So that's what they mean by marketing automation, is actually just integrating their video solution into those platforms. And analytics, now this is part of any video hosting platform or any marketing platform for that matter. Analytics into viewer insight, engagement, locations, things like that. Now there is one section of their marketing plan that is not included in Dub, and that's live streaming. So Dub does not offer any form of live streaming. So this is going to be something unique for Brightcove and what they offer. So that is the only thing that's going to be separate between these two platforms is the live streaming. Now social publishing, being able to publish your videos from one central location, that's also going to be provided by Dub. So this is the marketing plan that we've talked about. Now we won't go into too deep of detail of each of these solutions. It's going to get really complicated really quickly. We're just taking a brief overview of what we're getting out of this platform. So using the marketing suite, this is what we're getting. And also we talked about the video cloud solution. Now they actually offer a free trial to this, and that's what we're taking a look at here. Part of it's accessible, where you can upload manager media and view analytics. But then the gallery here, where you're able to build those video pages and things like that, those are not part of the free trial. So that's basically what this looks like though. This is here, the dashboard for Brightcove. So that's what the platform is. We're going to talk about pricing in just a second as well. But let's go ahead and actually compare this to Dub. So we have Dub here on the right. We're going to expand this. So this is what Dub looks like. Now we're going to take a look at those video pages, because these ones you can actually build on a free trial. So here's what that looks like with the branding, the call to actions. Some of this functionality is going to be the same between the two platforms, but what Dub has done is really taken these call to actions a step further. Things like direct calendar integration, video testimonial capture, form fill, third-party forms, internal forms, lots and lots of different functionality here with the call to actions, as well as playlists. And now Brightcove will offer playlists as well, just not in the same format where they're going to play automatically kind of back to back. Other than that, the video pages or video portals, if you call them, are going to be pretty similar. But the call to actions are really the distinction there. They're not just link-based. They're actually interactive, multi-purpose call to actions. Like I said, form fills, calendar integration, video testimonial collection, and more. So that's really the difference between the video portal or video page options between the two platforms. So that's one thing. The next thing was the marketing automation. Now, as I mentioned, with Brightcove, the marketing automation is just an integration into a third-party platform, whereas with Dub, the marketing automation is built in. Now, this includes both email and SMS marketing automation, so you can build out campaigns, the one-time sends, bulk emails, bulk SMS messages, and then also automatic workflows that contain both emails and text messages dispersed throughout. And like I said, that is actually something built into Dub, automatically included. And now here's just a quick example of what one of those campaigns looked like. Here was one that was sent out to 17,000 plus people. And we can see super detailed analytics right here in the dashboard of who watched, who clicked, who engaged in what manner, and at what time and what location. So all of those things tracked right down to the very specific details right from within the Dub dashboard. So no need for a third-party marketing automation system. Although if you do have one of those systems, Dub can integrate with those as well. So that is what the marketing automation comparison looks like. With Brightcove, it is a matter of integrating with a third-party system, and with Dubs, it's built in. Now, with analytics, those are comparable as well. So they're going to have a little analytics dashboard, just like Dub does. What Dub actually does as well is they include the analytics at a campaign level, like this here. You can see the campaign. Also at a video level, how a specific video performed, and then also just generic performance on a dashboard of how all of your videos are performing and things like that. So it's really more of a user portal instead of just for one company. So that's probably another one of the differences, is this isn't necessarily tied to any one user unless it's like the chief marketing officer or someone like that who's got their boots to the ground when it comes to marketing and content creation and video production and things like that. That's who it would actually be this portal for. Whereas with Dub, this portal is actually accessible to both salespeople, marketers, marketing, you know, startups, or just small business owners that don't necessarily call themselves any one of those hats. So this is really the difference, is this is a portal that is really user-friendly and accessible to any business owner, like I said, or any employee in a business, from sales to marketing to PR, whatever. So that's really the difference here, is this is more of the head of marketing or the person who's in charge of marketing or video solutions. That's kind of the difference. Okay. So next thing we're looking at is the content management, which is pretty straightforward as well. We can see here there's the library. You can organize them by folders and things like that. Same thing goes with Dub, except for there's a tagging system. So you can keep things tagged by that. You can search for them by name. We have teams, individual videos, my videos, things like that. So lots of ways to kind of isolate these and break them apart. We can bulk delete and things like that. And tag and manage them at scale. So those features are very similar as well. And we talked about the analytics. So this is what we've covered in the marketing plan, how they're very similar. What Dub does is really take it a step further for each of these. The video portals are going to have more customization with the call to actions, and then also the tracking, and then also the marketing automation is in-house or with third-party systems. So more limitation or more feature set there. Analytics are basically the same. Content management is comparable. Social publishing, also really similar. From one spot, you can post to different channels. Live streaming is going to be the only thing that Brightcove includes in their marketing package that Dub does not include in its packages. So the other thing here that we talked about was the video hosting. So that's not included in this list right here, but it's just a video cloud solution. And that's pricing based off a couple of things. And so that there's not a whole lot to that. It's just some basic embedding, video embedding options and video hosting. So we won't dive into too deep of the specifics of that, but we will talk about some pricing. So what we've done is just compared Brightcove's marketing and video cloud solution to Dub's plan, which is really an all-in-one solution, and it's all inclusive. So let's go ahead and now compare the prices of these two. We've looked at some of the features. If you need more information on any of these specific features, there's full videos where we really dive in deep. The other difference here in the marketing package that Dub includes is the video creation tools. Brightcove doesn't offer any ability to create videos. So that's where they have the live streaming. That's where Dub has its video creation and real-time editing tools. They have some really powerful features, things like pausing, uploading your own profile pictures, resizing the webcam, and then also the ability to add virtual backgrounds. So here's what that virtual background actually looks like. We can see it's in real-time editing, as well as the pause functions, the ability to turn the webcam on and off. Things like that are designed to make real-time editing to where you don't have to do as much in post, and we can get these videos out really quickly and show the things that we need to. This entire video was actually shot using Dub's real-time editing features. So that is what we've compared. Now, let's go ahead and wrap things up. We've talked about the differences and the similarities between the two platforms, and now let's talk about pricing. So we talked about the video solution, the video hosting pricing. Got some information here. Pricing isn't quite available on Brightcove's website. They're not going to list any types of pricing there. But through some research on the internet, we can see what they offer. As of the end of last year in November, they offered some express solutions starting at $99 per month, $199 per month, and $499 per month for just the video hosting solution. So this is their video storage, just the embedding options and things like that. So this actually doesn't include the other things that we talked about in their marketing suite. This is just 50 videos and 40 gigabytes of bandwidth and some account management and things like that. So that's where their pricing starts, just for the video cloud solution, $99 per month. And now the other solution was the marketing one. We talked about that. And again, the information isn't quite available on their site, but through a little bit of research, we can see it starts at $199 per month for the starter, the intro to the marketing package. And of course, there's tiers here. So there's probably a few things beyond just that starter package, all the way up to enterprise, and depending on the number of users and volume and things like that. So, but that's where the packages start, $199 per month for the marketing package and $99 per month for the video hosting solution. Over at Dub, the prices are a little bit more straightforward. Everything is in one package. We do have a starter package that is $0 per month. There's not a lot of branding and things like that, so we want to make sure that all our own branding and logos and call to actions, we're really getting the most out of it, because it's very, very affordable. So this is what's just $32 per month if paid for the year in advance. If you go month to month, it's only $40 per month. And then that's comparable to Bread Cove's, you know, $200 for their marketing package. We've already kind of compared those two things and realized that Dub has everything that Bread Cove would on their marketing package, everything except for live video. But in place of live video, it has real-time live video recording controls and features. And then it also has an entire built-in marketing automation system, including the ability to send out text messages and emails through campaigns and workflows and things like that. So definitely getting a lot more out of that $32 per month or $40 per month compared to the $200 or even the $100 that you're getting with just the video hosting. So included in that $30 or $40 per month is unlimited video hosting, multiple embedding options, and then also CTAs and things like that on those embedded videos. So I highly recommend checking it out. I know both of them is just as a 30-day trial, but just for the video cloud, doesn't offer any of the customization options. Dub's free trial does offer access to just about everything they have, I think, except for maybe the marketing automation component. So check that out. Check out a free trial if you haven't already. And I'm sure you're going to come to the same conclusion as I am. Unless you're needing to live stream your content and monetize your stuff with paywalls and ads server side, then your hosting solution is going to be better off with Dub. Thanks for your time, guys.